Here we have 6.6, rationalize the denominator quotient involving a higher radical. So these, you really want to put them in their prime factorization form. So I'm going to have the 4th root of 2 over the 4th root of 27 is 3 times 9, and 9 is 3 times 3. So the prime factorization would be 3 to the 3rd power. Now, I need a 4th root. So how many more 3's do I need? If I've got 3 of them, how many more do I need so that I can cancel out the 4th root? I would need 4 total, which means I need an extra 1. So I need this guy so that I will have 3 to the 4th power, and then I can take the 4th root of 3 to the 4th power. But whatever I do to the bottom, I have to do the same to the top. So I'm going to multiply those insides together. I get the 4th root of 6. I'm going to multiply these two together, but I'm going to use the exponent form. So when you multiply bases the same, you add the exponents. And then we know a 4th power and a 4th root undo each other. And so this is the final expression. This is not one that you can do in the calculator, because the calculator would just give you a decimal answer. And Alex is going to want the exact answer that involves the root. Similarly, we can do the same here. If I put that in its prime factorization, it would be this 2 and then the cube root of 5 squared. So now the index is 3, which means I need 3 as my exponent in order for them to cancel. So that means I need an extra 1 so that when I'm done, I have 3 and 3. Okay? But whatever you do to the bottom, you have to do the exact same thing to the top. So I end up with 2 cube root of 5 in the top and cube root of 5 cubed at the bottom. And then these two undo each other and I end up with 2 cube root of 5 over a regular 5. And that's the end of rationalizing that. Now, if this 2 and this 5 could have been simplified, then I would have had to have done that. But 2 and 5 do not reduce, so I'm done for that problem.